Today's morning minute, kingdom living is sitting at the king's table. There's a knock at the door. You open the door and the people at the door tell you the king wants to see you. Are you running away from the King of Kings, or are you seeking all he has for you? He's knocking at the door of your heart. He wants you to eat with him and sit at his table as a son or daughter. Are you running from the Father's embrace of love? Are you running from what is best in your life? Are you running from the joy of the Lord? Are you running from his rest and shalom peace? Are you blaming God for your condition in life and running from him? Your spiritual heritage is to run away from God, not towards God, because of the disobedience of your ancestors, Adam and Eve. You were born with a disobedient and sinful nature, which has caused you to be crippled as the son of shame in rebellion against God, like Mephibosheth, King Saul's grandson. Mephibosheth was running away from King David. Mephibosheth was the grandson of King Saul and grew up in the palace, knowing his grandfather hated David and wanted him killed. So when his grandfather Saul died, he ran from the newly crowned King David because he had heard his grandfather's hate towards David. Saul was an enemy of David. Saul was trying to kill David. Saul hated David and pursued David until Saul's death. On the same day he heard the news of the death of his grandfather, Mephibosheth fell and became paralyzed. His name before the accident was Merib-Baal, meaning opponent of Baal, which is the false god. After he became paralyzed, his name was changed to Mephibosheth, son of shame. The first order of business for David as king was to determine if anyone was still alive from Saul's family, so he could show God's kindness, love, and mercy to them. Here is King David now showing kindness to the family who hated him and wanted him killed. And we read in 2 Samuel chapter 9, verses 6 and 8, when Mephibosheth, son of Jonathan, the son of Saul, came to David, he bowed down to him with honor. David said, Mephibosheth, at your service, he replied. Don't be afraid, David said to him, for I will surely show you kindness for the sake of your father Jonathan. I will restore to you all the land that belonged to your grandfather Saul, and you will always, always, always eat at my table. Mephibosheth bowed down and said, what is your servant that you should notice a dead dog like me? God wants you to sit at his table with him to feast and enjoy all he has for you. He wants to restore you back to your rightful position before the accident. Your name is changed from the son of shame to the child of God. The king has healed your crippled legs of shame, guilt, condemnation, rebellion, and selfishness. He wants you to sit with your legs under his banquet table and enjoy his food of righteousness forever. Stop running away and run towards Christ, your Redeemer, Healer, Sustainer, Provider, Abundance, Comforter, Shalom, Peace, and Lord. All the legal rights and the privileges of the kingdom of God are yours now. Amen and amen.